He is one of the best defenders in the game, and he hopes to be leading what could be the best defense in the game this year. Minkah Fitzpatrick, how's camp going so far?
Yeah, it's going good. It's going good. It's been competitive. It's been fun. We're getting better. We're paying attention to our details. And, you know, like you said, we're trying to be one of the best of the best. So we're trying to compete and trying to get better.
You guys lose Bud Dupree through free agency, but you had Melvin Ingram. What has he kind of brought to the defense and that pass rush to help you get those interceptions that are going to change the game?
He had something that we really needed was experience. You know what I'm saying? He's a guy that's been in the league for a long time and has played at a super high level. He's super intelligent. He's a thinker. He's a guy that's always asking why and how and what. You know what I'm saying? He's not just going with the flow of things. You know, and we need that. You know what I'm saying? He's teaching guys like Alex Highsmith when to rush certain ways and when to play the run. You know what I'm saying? Stuff like that. And, you know, nothing really beats experience, no matter how skilled you are. We got experience. It definitely helps us out a whole lot.
Statistically speaking, last year you were a top five defense. And that was even when the offense was having its struggles and you guys had to probably take a few more snaps a game than you otherwise would have. What indications, what reasons are there that you guys could be the best defense in the league this year?
I think one is that we're going to, you know, we didn't lose a whole lot of people. We lost some key people, but we have a lot of our vets back. A lot of guys that, you know what they're doing back. A lot of guys that love the game, you know what I'm saying, that came in and are new, but they're doing what they can to contribute. And you know, I think our offense got a whole lot better as well with the addition of Najee and a whole bunch of different offensive linemen and receivers. So I think, you know, they're going to do their job. They're going to be one of the best offenses in the league this year, and we'll kind of work hand-to-hand.
What is it about Alabama? You said Najee, he comes in, and it seems like he's ready to go right in. You hop into this defense, you're ready to go in the mid-season trade. Yeah. What is it about Alabama that gets you guys ready and prepared for the pros?
I think it's because we're going against the best of the best every day. You know what I'm saying? And we're being coached by one of the best. You know, I'm seeing guys like Calvin Ridley, Jerry Jeudy, Devontae Smith every single day. You know what I'm saying? And like, those are all first rounders. But like Henry Ruggs, all these different guys. Najee's going against Reuben Foster, Rashawn Evans. And those are two first rounders right there. You know what I'm saying? So, that competition that you see every day, it prepares you for when you step on this stage and you're seeing those guys week to week, even though it's from different schools, but they're first rounders and they're great players. So, even if they're not first rounders, they're great players. So, I think just seeing that every single day, every single rep, you know, you have to get A++ every single rep.
We saw Najee Harris for a handful of touches in the Hall of Fame game, but there wasn't really, you know, it wasn't a full featured, obviously, a game. Has he done anything in practice? Steelers fans want to know. Fantasy football fans want to know. Has Najee done anything in practice that you were like, oh, yeah, that's why he's supposedly the best back coming?
Honestly, the very first day that he was here, he had a crazy one-handed catch fade. He's at number one in the end zone. You're in the fade on the linebacker. Linebacker's in a great position. He just went up and just snagged it right out of the air. And I was like, I was in the middle of the field and I was running towards it. I just stopped. I was like, damn. Like, that was nice, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, he's a very talented dude. He's a great dude off the field, too. So, I love him.
Expectations for the AFC North. Again, offensive linemen's kind of been, that whole group is being worked. Defense has some pieces coming back with Bush and obviously Melvin Ingram being out there. What is your expectations as the Steelers in this AFC North in this year?
I mean, our expectation is to win it. You know what I'm saying? That's what we come in, you know, expecting. That's how we prepare. You know what I'm saying? We're not making no excuses, no comfort seeking. It don't matter, you know, who's out there. We're going to go out there trying to win, trying to dominate. You know what I'm saying? Last year, I feel like we did a good job starting off, and then we kind of fell off, you know, losing to Cleveland twice, you know, back to back. You know, it wasn't a good look. And it don't matter if the starters weren't out there in that second game. Like, we still go out there and try to win. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, we're going out there this year for the AFC North Super Bowl, whatever you want to call it. And we're trying to win.
Much of the football world, when they talk about the Steelers, is talking about Ben Roethlisberger. How many more throws does he have? How much more time does he have? You get to see him, and you've seen him in practice now for a couple few years.
Yeah.
How's he looking so far in camp?
He looks like Ben Roethlisberger. Really? Like, all these people that are saying this and that about him, they don't know what they're looking at. You know what I'm saying? He's making all the throws that he made 10 years ago. His arm looks good. He's making deep passes, accurate deep passes. You know, he's still reading the game and playing the game like he's used to. You know, I think people are just associating his age with his skill. You know, not thinking, you know, this is still a top 10, top 5 quarterback. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, I think people are just hating on him, to be honest with you.
One last question for you. This is a Steelers weekend. You guys kicked it off with the Hall of Fame game. Saturday, we from Steelers. Today we're going to hear from another Steeler as well. I mean, this franchise is it's as good as it gets, obviously, in pro football, maybe in professional sports. As a current Steeler, are you inspired by what you've seen from the Hall of Fame weekend and the Steelers of the past?
Oh, yeah, for sure. You know, when you see guys like Troy Polamalu, you know what I'm saying, you know, up there getting his enshrinement and, you know, getting his jacket and whatnot. It's definitely inspiring, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, when I first got here and I was making my plays, you know, obviously we're not the same player. You know, people were, you know, saying, oh, he has the same playmaking ability as Troy Polamalu and whatnot. You know, that's inspiring to me because just to be compared to a guy like that, it's like man, these people, I really think I'm an elite player like him. So it's definitely achievable. It's definitely attainable. And it makes it even more realistic when you see these people, when you see these players that, you know, that you're following in the footsteps of.
Make a Fitzpatrick one of the best.